Right, guys, so today we're gonna change the spark plugs and the valve cover gasket for this 2008 Mazda CX-7 2.3 turbo. So first thing is to remove these rivets here, one here. There you go. Let's take it off. Put it on this side. Okay. So as you can see, we have our valve cover gasket under this filter here, so need to take it out. So we'll see. All right, so remove this bolt. Okay, so this is number 10 and this is number 8, I don't know. So or not. Take it off. All right, so now we're going to remove the hose clamp that is here. It's at number 10. Alright. And also there is the number 10 hose here. Hose clamp number 10. Connect this line here and also this line over here. Okay, so let me show you what I'm doing. All right, so you have to disconnect this line, this hose here, and this clamp here, and this clamp right here. So all right, so that's what I'm doing. the flat head screwdriver. Disconnect this hose. So now we have to remove this bolt here. Just 1, 2, 3. We got 3 bolts. Okay, so this so. So this is 12 millimeter. guys. So so now we have to remove this one, it's disconnected. Let's remove this ground here. This is number 8. So now remove the ignition coils. The bulb cover gasket. this line here. Just come up on this side. Alright guys, so I removed this hose, so the only thing you have to do is press this down like this, and just be careful to not break this quick connector. So now we're gonna remove the valve cover gasket. So with a flat screwdriver, let's see. Okay, so one more bolt. So okay, so now the valve cover gasket is, we need to clean really careful this area right here. Need to remove the silicone, this one here. Need to remove silicone, this area here. Thank you. So I'm gonna clean it. I'll be right back. All right, guys. So now we're gonna grab a sandpaper. I like to use the P500. That works better for me. So just to sand this area here. Remember, it needs to be really clean. Really good cleaning here. Alright, so I'm gonna sandpaper down everything, so I'll be right back. Alright, guys, so as you can see, everything is clean now. So, you know, when you change the valve cover, it's a good idea to also change the spark plugs. So, let's do it. Alright, guys, so for this car, the OEM spark plugs are the ENGK Iridium. They also came pre-gap, so you don't have to gap. But to make sure it's got the gap is between 0.028 inch to 0.028. 31, so this one has 29, so it's perfect. So all right, so thank you. Okay, so now I got my little hose here. Let's put it here. This one. You know, I always like to torque the spark plug, so this one is 10 foot pounds. So all right, guys, so now I'm gonna cover this a little bit. I'm gonna change this bolt cover gasket. So I'm gonna remove this. So now we have to clean inside here. Remove the oil. All right, so always use a brake cleaner to clean the valve cover gasket. So so now have our valve cover gasket. Okay. Make sure you push the bolts up. There we go. That's one. Just take the time. Alright guys, so alright guys, so that's good. So now grab a little bit of blade cleaner, put on the rack, and just clean the bolt cover. So just put it on the side. Alright guys, so now take this off with a clean rag. I'm gonna clean it one more time. Make sure it's dry. There you go. So now we're gonna add a little bit of silicone on this part right here. This line right here. I'm gonna show you in a little bit. We also wanna add some silicone in this area here. And this area here. Okay, so let me show you where I put the silicone. So, silicone goes in this area here, where is the valve cover, the timing cover. This area here, and also some silicone in this half circle here, one corner and the other corner here. So. That's the area that you need to put some silicone, just to make sure there's no more oil leaks on the future. So, alright guys, so install the valve cover, install right here. Oh no. It wasn't like that, it was like that. That's better. Okay. There we go. So I'm gonna stir from the middle. Okay, so this bolts right here goes torque at between 7 or 8, so I wanna do 8. So I'm gonna do 7 instead of 8. So now we're gonna do a double check. There you go. Okay, so now install the coils. This connect this one, put the ground. All right, guys. So now you have to put the little turbo air filter in this area, and so almost. So when you put it, you're done. So just put it together. It's easier to put it apart. So, all right, guys. Thank you very much for watching. I hope that this video can help you fixing your Mazda or doing your tune-up. Thank you guys for watching.